Good afternoon, students, families, friends, and alumni. Welcome to the 119th Annual Gym Drill at Bryn Mawr School. Each year in May, Gym Drill serves as an opportunity to connect and unite generations of students. Gym Drill holds a unique and valuable place, not only in the history of Bryn Mawr, but in the history of dance education in our country. In its original form, Gym Drill served to boldly prove that women were, indeed, able to move and exercise just as men were. Over time, our Gym Drill has evolved to include dances that embrace the diversity of the larger world around us and in our own community. Dance can be taught through the lens and the embodiment of history, of math, of culture, visual art, music, physical education, and science. Perhaps it serves as a physics lesson on torque, a geometry lesson, or to reflect upon our past and inform the future. Dance is storytelling, it is brain science, it is painting, sculpting, self-expression. And here, at Bryn Mawr, dance is a celebration and rite of passage as each grade symbolically moves on to the next. After three less than typical years of Gym Drill, we couldn't be more thrilled to be here outside performing for you all. Thank you all so much for joining us. We are so excited for this beautiful weather. We are joined here together on the historic land of the Piscataway, which is now known as Baltimore, Maryland. Please join me in acknowledging this community, their elders, past and present, as well as future generations. And now, for the Alumni March. Music, begin. class of 1998. Two members of the class of 98 currently work at Primark Support Services, Ellen Roosevelt and Farrah Hines Evans. Welcome back, class of 2000. Welcome back, class of 2001. Welcome, 2002. And for their 20th reunion, the class of 2003. Making their way to their places, and we will begin as soon as they are ready. Now, I would like to introduce Gym Girl 2023. Music, begin.
Thank you. Keep your head up, oh.
gather your props and come forward for your dance. While the sixth graders are gathering their props, I want to take a moment to thank the Upper School History Department for their hard work in researching and presenting historical information on many of the dances that are being performed today. Inspired by Junior Zayden Richardson, this is a great opportunity for our students to learn more about the history of the dances that they worked so hard to learn. The sixth graders will perform a Chinese parasol dance. Chinese folk dances reach back to ancient times, rooted strongly in Chinese culture and history. From festival celebrations to ritualistic and religious ceremonies, the Chinese have cultivated a folk dance for many different lifetime events. The umbrella or parasol dance was very popular during the Han Dynasty and originated in an area called Jinzhou. Jinzhou natives present umbrellas that are considered valued gifts at weddings, birthdays, and funerals. Performed mostly during the Lantern Festival. The basic movements are rolling, twisting, gripping, and turning the umbrellas. Music begins. Of the local tarantula spider was frenzied dancing. This supposed cure was the inspiration for this fun and frenetic dance. Music begins. Longsword dances are associated with England, and they have been traced to many mainland locations in Europe. These dances have been a part of English life for over 600 years, and several references appear in works of Shakespeare. Sword dances were traditionally performed by men, although now there are many groups of dancers throughout England, men and women, who perform various sword dances throughout the year. This year, we are performing a variation called Ask Em Richard. Ask Em Richard is a small town south of York, England, which is a town of 351 people, and the name means composure of the ash trees. This dance, when performed in its entirety, has a storyline that includes characters, such as a king and a queen, two band bearers, among others. We will share just a portion of the dance with you today. Music begins.
Thank you.
The sophomores are performing the Kuku, a West African dance with origins in Guinea, Senegal, and the Ivory Coast. Originally performed by women returning from fishing, the dance has evolved over time and is danced by both men and women. We were fortunate to have Brenmar Parent and dance professional Kwame Apari come to teach us this dance in December 2013. It is a fast and fun dance to perform. Center group shift. And music begins. Displays are renowned, and the gifts of song and dance play a large part in the culture. Each of the 15 islands that make up the Cook Islands has a different technique, which make their performances unique. Common movements you might see are swaying hips, feet flat to the ground, and still shoulders, while hands and fingers perform gentle, waving motions. Today, the seniors are performing two dances, Ta Reo, followed by Rapa Nui. And music, begin.
Thank you.
Called the Carpathian Kopec, often referred to as the National Dance of Ukraine. Kopec is a Cossack dance that has its origins in the early 16th century. This Kopec is from the Carpathian Mountains. Special thanks to the Kopec family for bringing this dance to our lives. Maria Kopecki from the class of 2016 and her sister Lina from the class of 2018 taught us this dance. Special thanks to their father, Nora, the headdresses are referred to as vinas from Kiev. The headdresses are filled with red poppies, which is an important symbol in Ukrainian culture. Music, begin.
Thank you.
year's senior dance was choreographed by Kelsey Lewis, Olivia West, and Nyla Wilson. And seniors, you give me the sign when you're ready. All right, music, begin. First and foremost, Allison, Amelia, and Anna Bryan, thank you for everything. Your dance expertise is admirable, and your humor and camaraderie is so very appreciated. To our Security, Grounds, and Operations Department, thank you for all that you do to keep our campus safe and beautiful, not just this weekend, but all year round. Special thanks to Rob and Tommy for helping us blow up the field at 7 a.m. And thank you to John Sapp and Jim Grinnell for setting up our third grade Maypole performance this morning. John, we wish you all the best as you retire from Bryn Mawr. Your institutional knowledge of everything Bryn Mawr, and especially Bizarre, Maypole, and Gingerl, is invaluable, and you will be missed by all. Greg Shirk, thank you for your outstanding work as our sound engineer, not only for Gingerl, but for so many Bryn Mawr events. Thank you to our chief advisors and a couple who are standing in today, Rance Denton, Kristen Hall, Gina Constraro, Anne O'Brien, Claire Sargo, Tilly Taborda Almaguer, Rebecca Wish, and Molly Wood. Thank you for keeping everyone in attendance and organized during our rehearsals. Thank you to the athletic department, Tina, Molly, Maggie, and Stacey Watson, thank you for helping us go out the field and your ongoing support. Thank you to Ann Broadus and Mimi Walters for your fantastic help with the fifth grade, who will be marching with us later. And you will be missed as you retire from Bryn Mawr. Thank you for always lending me a helping hand with all things Gingerl and being one of the biggest cheerleaders for this important tradition. Jeanette Budzik and Gina Canestraro, thank you for all of your support and institutional knowledge of this day, as well as your work behind the scenes. And Terry, if you're tuning in from home, thank you for your continued support from afar. We appreciate it. And one last thank you as the seniors are making their way out, and that is to the PE office mates, Mimi Walters, Michelle Sapp, Tilly Taborda Almaguer, and Camille McCarroll for endless support and laughs along the way. Seniors, how you doing? While they're coming out, I will talk about our closing dance this year. We have not done a closing dance in a couple years, and this year we learned a new Greek dance, Elia Showalter and Maria Showalter. Elia is a freshman and Maria is a junior, and they taught us this dance. The dance is called Ikariotiko and has its origins from the Greek island of Ikaria. Oftentimes when you see this dance, the participants would spiral in, but for our purposes, we are doing an inner and outer circle. Seniors, you might want a few more people in the inner. Thank you. Okay, seniors, do we have everybody? Okay. Here we go. Music, begin. Thank you. job, everyone. Fantastic work on that new dance. All students, if you could head towards the back of the field for the banner march. While the students are taking their places, I would like to again thank the students and families who have brought new ideas for dances to the dance teachers here at Bryn Mawr. It is always our goal to learn, teach, and perform world and cultural dances with as much accuracy and authenticity as possible. Joining us today, getting set up in the front. And the banner march serves as a symbolic transition from one grade moving up to the next. Now we prepare for the banner march. Music, begin. We need to continue, sorry. At this time, awards will be given to seniors by our head of school, Sue Sadler, dance teacher, Anne O'Brien, and our all-school captain, Grace Martin. Seniors are receiving a pin with the school insignia on it. Seniors, as I call your name, please come forward. Amari Adams. Marguerite Antonitis. Lucia Ayala. McKenna Bachman. Maggie Baffy. Juliana Bartlett. Bridget Bauman. Maggie Belbot. Elena Ballone. Logan Betke. Christina Butkins. Grace Black. Mia Boydston. Samantha Brecker. Natalie Kai. Charlotte Cameron. Kate Cashin Panos. Nile Tullers. Amara Danchin. Ashi Daniel. Alex De Jesus. Anvita Deshpande. Kiara Dres Pedra. Charlotte Easter. Jane Eisberg. Lola Evanhoff. Arzu Bayazi. Mackenzie Fisher. Claire Gibson. Celine Gonzalez Santos. Katrina Hall. Beth Petrick. Leon Hanush. Olivia Hood. Roxy Hopkins. Caitlin Hurley. Maddie Keith. Meriwether King. Story Polinich Urban. Naria Lemma. Kelsey Lewis. Leah Lewis. Grace Blue. Maggie Lynch. Sabrina MacArthur. And Grace Martin, who's already down the field. Lizzie Mills. Nellie Mills. Ella Moore. Katie Nelson. Francesca Polito. Julia Powell. Elise Purcell. Maya Riedick. Spencer Richmond. Sophia Sabatino. Meredith Schatz. Anna Schaefer. Rachel Shin. Lydia Sides. Annie Soon. Christina Susu. Carolyn Sue. JJ Suriano. Hallie Triplett. Maddie Turnbaugh. Eliza Turrell. Inkesenye Utbu. Abby Watson. Meryl Watson. Olivia West. Nyla Wilson. Ariel Wilson. Grace Woods. Reese Woodworth. Asha Worley. Yasmin Worley. Caroline Wu. Sue Yin. And Catherine Zick. Congratulations, seniors. Now I'd like to invite our all-school captain, Grace Martin, to come to the podium to say a few words.
Hey guys. For the past 7 years, I've struggled through every single dance class. Some people are said to have a natural gift for dance. I'm most definitely not one of those people. In fact, I've been told on multiple occasions that I make dancing look very difficult. And yet, anyone who's ever shared a dance class with me knows that it's my favorite class. This is for exactly one reason, gym drill. Gym drill marks the end of a year's worth of dance classes. Usually, endings make me queasy. I hate final exams. I always prefer practices over track meets. and season finales bum me out. You may be wondering, Grace, how have you been coping with the end of high school? Thank you for checking in. It's not going well. I think it's because endings always feel unsatisfactory to me. They feel like unfair assessments of the time and energy that I put into something. I mean, how is one moment supposed to sum up a year's worth of work? However, gym drill is the opposite of superficial. What you see today is an honest testament to the Bryn Mawr culture. Sure, our polos might be a little bit cleaner, and there isn't a pair of sweatpants in sight, but the characteristics being displayed today are integral to the school. There's nothing performative about this day. Each gym drill is unique in its own way. However, as I reflect upon the pieces of Bryn Mawr culture that are here today, I notice some common threads between every gym drill that I have experienced. There are, of course, the most common constants, being yelled at by Coach Wolf for being out of place during rehearsal, attempting to balance turf on innocent bystanders while waiting for the cultural dances to begin, genuinely fearing for your life as someone recklessly stabs a safety pin into your sash, and being whisper screamed at to wheel faster by people on the inside of the banner march who literally have to take 2-inch steps while you're taking 2-foot steps. But there are also the less obvious constants of gym drill. They're the things that not only make gym drill the best tradition, but also are what make Bryn Mawr such a special place. The first constant is togetherness. Dancing with each other today, we feel the closest we've ever been. While the dances ensure physical proximity to each other, the memorable piece is the emotional unity. We are all working towards the same goals today. Don't mess up, and don't make the dance teachers mad. Regardless of the differences that separate us, gym drill provides a common ground. No matter who you are, by being here, you're a part of gym drill. Nobody here is alone. The second constant is selflessness. Gym drill only exists while we are willing to sacrifice for it. If only one of us had been here dancing today, it would have looked absolutely ridiculous. But when each and every one of us consciously decides to spend our Saturday here, we are a part of something big, something meaningful. Someone recently told me that significance is what we contribute to others. If we have an impact on the world around us, it will have been through the ways we affected each other. Today, as we put our individual lives aside and dance for each other, we become a part of something significant. As I said earlier, the factors of gym drill don't feel performative because we live them every day. When I think back on this past year, and really every year that I've gotten to spend with the class of 2023, I realize that I've never struggled to find the togetherness and selflessness that are so clear on this day. There was always a friendly face to greet us in the morning. There was always someone to comfort you on the senior room couch. And if there's one thing our grade had, it was people who had the ability to make you laugh. I don't think I'll ever forget the toilet shin guard mystery of 2016, the anatomically correct deer skeleton outside a party, or the person who parked illegally every single day despite having her first and last name plastered on a bumper sticker on her car. I don't like endings, and I stink at dancing, and yet somehow I have the opportunity to conclude a speech on my last gym drill as all-school captain. It's funny how that worked out. For those of you with 7 years left, or even 1 year left, look at the people around you. Think about the ways that in which they have shown you togetherness and selflessness. Not just today, but on every day. Be there for them. One day, when it's your very last gym drill, you might just be thanking them for getting you through school. The little memories you make here don't feel significant until you're looking back at them, getting ready to say goodbye. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Grace. As Grace is making her way back to join her class, I do want to take a moment to acknowledge the senior class for their commitment to this tradition. In their 4 years of upper school, they have experienced 4 different versions of gym drill. from the 2020 Zoom event to a modified 2021 to an inside 2022. And finally, today, a beautiful outside full-scale gender roll event. Seniors, it's been a pleasure and an honor to have taught each and every one of you this year. Now, students, please rise for the banner march. Class captains are elected from the front line. 10 dancers each year are chosen by their dance teachers for each grade, and then students vote on who they choose to be their class captain. Music, begin. And class captains, mark time. March and left, 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 right, left. Accepting the sixth grade banner for the fifth grade is Mary Frances Rivera. Accepting the seventh grade banner for the sixth grade is class captain Kiki Noyce. Violet Schoenbacher. Accepting the ninth grade banner for the eighth grade is class captain Charlotte Wedlaufer. Accepting the 10th grade banner for the ninth grade is class captain Sunny Weaver. The 11th grade banner for the 10th grade is class captain Carmen Lennon. Accepting the 12th grade banner for the 11th grade is class captain Ryan Myers. Ryan is receiving the banner from 12th grade class captain Amari Adams. Yeah.